Greetings for the Earthlings, welcome back to Delta Force 2. We are actually addressing a hidden mission in Operation Common Resolve. Now notice the fact that I'm calling it a hidden mission and not a secret mission. The reason behind that is, well, you can't exactly unlock it through conventional means by gathering some intel at some other mission or whatever. You actually need to use a hex editor to open up the save file and change a few values so that you can actually mark this mission as already having been completed, and then you can play it. Now, I don't know why this wasn't a part of the game. Maybe the developers forgot to hardcode it in, but this was around the time that over the network patches were already a thing, but so I think this might have been like a very easy fix for the developers, even if that was the case. So I suppose this was more of a cut mission from the game, so maybe it just doesn't really, you know, fit into the narrative. Now with this mission, both the campaigns, Common Resolve and Global Enforcement, are at 14 missions each, including the secret missions of course. So this might just have been a part of the general flow of the campaign, which later got cut, putting Common Resolve down to 13 missions, including the secret mission. So anyway, as far as Global Enforcement is concerned, I have completely finished at this point in time, but I am going to release this mission to you guys first, just to maintain some semblance of continuity to the campaign. So anyway, we have prattled on for long enough. Let's go ahead and read what this has to say. Intel reports mobile SCUD launches along the border. Find the launches and lace them for artillery fire. Now, this is seemingly a pretty simple mission, although given how, well, you guys don't know it, but in Operation Global Enforcement, there's a similar mission called Steel Coffin, and that mission was, difficult. Anyhow, let's address the briefing.
Intel reports Daniil forces have deployed an unknown number of mobile SCUD launchers along Georgia's northwestern border. These launchers pose a significant threat and must be eliminated immediately. You are ordered to recon the area for SCUD launchers. Once identified, notify King 6 and laze the targets for artillery fire. You have a limited number of fire missions, so use them wisely. All teams rendezvous to the southwest for extraction. U-2 overflight reveals moderate foot patrols in the region. We have also identified several Russian-made ground attack helicopters. Proceed with caution.
Okay, so based on the map overview of this mission alone, I would say that we are fucked. Because, I mean, first of all, look at the amount of enemies there are on this in this tiny little area. At least it's a valley, but my god, the amount of enemies. And on top of all of that, they also have helicopters. So, of course, taking loss is supposed to be pretty much recommended at this point. I don't know how many fire missions we have authorizations for, but this is the first target, and then we head up here. These guys should not be too much of a hassle, but these two guys are what I'm really worried about. We would literally be sandwiched right in between them, where they can like target us for whatever reason. And there's, I don't know whether that's Alpha or Charlie, most likely Charlie, because Charlie comes with us and Alpha is like the last, the last consideration. But yeah, this seems like a difficult mission. I pray for my safety and sanity for that matter. Satchel charge, huh? I don't know about that. I don't know about satchel charges. But okay, if you guys recommend satchel charges, I will carry satchel charges with me. I'm going to go loud and proud. Let me go back there and check something. I think it might be wiser to... Yeah, I don't want to approach the bases, so I think it might just be wiser to carry a sniper instead. I don't know how wise, but I feel like it might just be the wiser option here. Now, I could carry the 50 caliber, the Barrett 50 cal, but however, this gun gives you more ammunition, given the fact that we're not exactly taking an extra load of ammo right here. We might as well stick to this loadout. Vicious luck.
King 6, this is Black Widow. All teams on the ground.
Acknowledge Black Widow. Break. King 6 to all King elements. Destroy every launcher you find. Stay low and keep it quiet.
Roger, King 6. But these guys here, I'm just gonna lay prone here and... Alpha...
This is Alpha 1.
We have eyes on multiple launchers southeast of Bravo's insertion point.
In my previous one, they did not alert anybody, which is quite surprising considering Alpha's track record. But there are lots of enemies here, like this entire valley, range of valleys, or rather, what do I call it? It's like a canyon, almost, but not exactly. Like this entire canyon range is full of enemies.
King 6, requesting fire mission, over.
King 6, Whiskey 1, send your fire mission, over.
Now, there are a couple of enemies that will come out of these houses, but they are not really the major issue. The major issue will be the entire plethora of enemies that will come out of the other side. Now, there are some enemies. Yeah, this guy here. He's going to start running at you, and then there are going to be more enemies coming in from all the way over there. Ooh, 800 meters, okay. I can have some fun
with
them.
This is truly one. We've got bad guys on the low ground.
Missed. Oh well. Time to get back to... And look at these guys. Literally walking around like T-800s. Without a single concern in the world. Come on, fire!
Alpha 1 is down!
Yeah, that's unfortunate.
Whoa, King 6! Alpha team is down!
I know, King 6, it happened right in front of me. Although I was wishing that Alpha team would remain alive. Unfortunately, they did. I don't know why some of these enemies do that. Walk at you like T-800s, but... yeah, there are some enemies that do that. That, in fact, like to do it. And these vehicles are... well, non-operational, so we don't really need to bother with them. But that being said, there are more enemies up ahead to our left. That guy had not died. Good thing I spotted him before he spotted me. And yeah. I'm not now going to make a break for it. I was hoping that Alpha would not die like the previous time around, but I suppose some things just remain in our hearts and minds without ever becoming reality. I mean, I suppose we all have our fantasies, right? I thought I saw somebody there. Sort of utilizing half cover there, that guy. The only drawback to the sniper is its low rate of fire. Whoops. Took some fall damage there. Used to hoping that it did not take fall damage again. And there are some people that are going to be shooting at us from there that we need to take care of. Zeroing in for 300 meters and trying to snipe out as many of these baddies as possible. Unfortunately, I only see two from here. And the thing about these hostiles, right, is the fact that... where am I being shot from? Is that you only get to see them properly once they're dead. Like, while they're alive, it's next to impossible to spot them from a range. Although, I would say that in this game, it is far easier to do so. In Delta Force 1, it was... I'm guessing that the enemies were just more pixelated in that game, so it made it sort of difficult to spot enemies that way. Is that an enemy? No, that's just a tree. Are those? No, those are also trees. But the shots are coming from somewhere over on that side. And I cannot figure out who's trying to shoot at me. I think I see somebody down there. Yes, I do. Now, I dare not crouch up and peek further, because that's only going to make things more problematic for me. Who's shooting at me? Who can shoot at me from that range? Is what I'm wondering. Those are trees. That is another tree. I'm scanning the mountain range at this point. Although this is not an engagement that I have any benefit in taking. Is that the enemy? Like literally glitching through the wall there? Well, what do you know it is? Or maybe not, who knows. Anyway, we're forsaking them and we're heading on. The reason I'm proning here is so that I don't suffer fall damage as I fall. It's a neat little trick. I mean, you just smoothly roll off and it doesn't really work unless you're proning, like unless you're going down a steep surface while you're prone, because if you try to be, you know, upright while pulling the same trick, you'll just you know, suffer fall damage anyway. So when you're prone like this, even if you fall like a couple of inches, you won't suffer any fall damage. And another thing that you guys probably don't notice is that I'm crawling towards my side, because for whatever reason, movement towards the side is actually faster than movement towards the front. And not just side, I mean it can be like towards the back as well. It's just movement towards the front that is a little slow. Movement on any other plane is perfect. Now, I'm actually not gonna go through that valley here, like through this valley here. I'm gonna stick to as much of an outside range as I can manage to do so. Like, take as broad of a range as possible. Because sticking to the valley will only make things worse for me. There are hostiles on either side, and they will shoot you dead. That is most likely an alive enemy. No longer. You were playing dead so intently that I thought to make your wish come true. Let's just take a moment to confirm whether we are actually headed towards the correct path or not. That was one of the scuds, and we'll have to come down here, and this is where we need to go. So I figure I'll take like the longer route around, circumvent the Black Widow, and try and lease the target from checkpoint Echo, because, well, it does not make sense to do things any other way, to me at least. Since there is like a nice feature which we can use for cover, we'll just go ahead and use that. Going through the valley, I feel like, is a suicide mission. And I'm personally not eager to commit suicide. Good to see that there's a way through here. We don't have to climb that mountain, this feature of the hill, or rather the mountain, or whatever you would like to call it. It's sort of like they wanted to draw mountains, but the reason I say that it seems like they wanted to draw mountains is the fact that there are... Oh, damn, that's a lot of enemies there. 800 meters, which is the maximum effective range of this weapon. I'm gonna shoot them all out, aren't I? I think one of them saw us. Oh no. And your turn. Now, what I personally like about this game is that even if you don't exactly hit your opponent, they still die. Like, even if you hit a little to the side of them, they will still die. There's probably some sort of bullet drift there, but yeah. I mean, I suppose I can see why this mission could have been cut from the final game, given how, you know, it does not fit the narrative and given how the level design is structured, because there's a lot of walking involved from one point to the other. Granted, we are taking the longer route around, but even if we were not taking the longer route around, it would still be quite a bit of a walk. So given all of that, I do suppose that I see why this mission is the way it is. Long walk, long walk, long walk, long walk. Scanning for hostiles, do not see anymore. Except for the ones I slew there. I hear a helicopter. Ground attack helicopter, apparently. Meant to take out troops from the air itself. And this guy is quite far off, apparently. I don't know, 815 meters. Can I? Nope, that is way too sensitive. I hear some kind of helicopter behind me. And at this point, I'm scared to look and see where it is. Because Delta Force 1 would sometimes do this, it would sometimes punish you for taking the more creative route around. Like if you go too far out of bounds, one of the helicopters might just randomly activate, which would otherwise never activate, for the record. But it could just randomly activate and kill you. Like it would absolutely know where you are at all times, and it would just smite you with the vengeance of the devs. So where are we currently? I think we should be somewhere around. I can't even tell at this point. Like, that's supposed to be our objective. And I do suppose that we are somewhere around here then. No, that's the guy that we sniped out. Okay. SCUD launches inside that valley. There were like a couple of SCUDs there that we took out during the insertion. And then what? Where are we then? I think we crossed this part right here. Grid lines, people. Yeah. That's where we are. And oh, we're right next to the extraction, which is something that I want to avoid. I want to go here. Now, there is somebody over there that might pose a problem, but I'm hoping that they won't. So what I'll do instead is objective marathon and vehicles. See, so there are like a bunch of SCUD launches there which we need to take out. So, oh, we can actually zoom in like that. That's nice. Now, the recommended pathway is absolutely insane. So we're not going to be obviously taking the recommended pathway, but I will start taking the road on the left here. We will avoid getting to the extraction, because in this game, getting to the extraction means an automatic victory, no matter what you have or have not, for that matter, done. So yeah, extraction is one of the things that we wish to avoid. Like getting to extraction, I mean. And I'm just trying to find a negotiable face for this mountain here. I think this is a rather negotiable face. Of course, I could be wrong. Come here. Yeah, sorry, there was a mosquito in front of my screen. I like crushing them with my hands. I hear a chopper and I think it's the Black Widow. I'm just gonna confirm once. Yes, yes it is. It's right in front of us. So what we'll do instead is we'll head straight east, and since we have gone beyond the extraction point, we will just climb up this hill as and when where we can. The thing is, I don't exactly want to engage in hostiles unless necessary. Oh, of course, there's like this little featurette between me and the objective, so we need to cross that. And that's Black Widow right there. Look at Black Widow in all its glory. Let's say, Black Widow, why don't you ever come to help us out with our missions, huh? Do you think you're something special? Just chilling around back here, not helping us out with the missions at all. Do you think that makes you special, huh? Why do you never come over and help us? Why is it, Black Widow? Why? Come on, I'm waiting for an answer there. And yeah, we just climb up this feature of the hill, and hopefully none of the enemies spot us while we're doing so. I've tried to take out as many as possible. And from here, we essentially will go to Checkpoint Echo and lease the targets that we want to lease carefully. Of course, unless we have to get to Checkpoint Echo, we will not be going all the way there. I'll try to avoid it for as long as possible. If the valley is visible from here itself, then that is all well and good. But I feel like the valley... Yeah, we're a little far off from the valley. It's around that bend there. So, my plan is to avoid detection entirely and prone to the point where I get to the top of the valley and just lease the targets from there. I have no ambitions whatsoever of engaging all of these enemies, because that is not what I'm here to do at any rate. And northeast is where we need to go if we want to get to the valley. And my primary concern is just that one dude, one sniper over on the ridge on the right, that guy over there. I hope that that guy does not make things difficult for us. And the fact that we have been given satchel charges sort of makes me nervous, to be honest, I'm not gonna lie. Is that the guy that we have already... No, of course not. Yeah, those are just guys that we have already taken out. Sorry, hit a few wrong keys there. It would suck to have taken such a roundabout path and still be victim to somebody's, some AI superior sniping. I suppose at this point I sort of understand what people talk about when they fear losing their jobs to AI. Apparently the sniper is somewhere over there, over in this direction, and I cannot see them, which makes me even more nervous, to be honest. Is that the sniper? I suppose it is. Seems to be the case. 700 meters. I sure hope there is a sniper and not... The guy's moving, so I'm gonna assume that he's a sniper. Maybe he's not the sniper. Maybe I'm just wasting my shots here and alerting everybody to my presence, but at any rate, let's keep going. Okay, that's the sniping party. Alright. They're closer. Far closer than I thought. My mouse sort of did not help me there for a moment, and I think that's all there is as far as the snipers are concerned. Now at this point I would like to prone down, and since we're like super close to... No, those were not the snipers. Those were not the snipers. Snipers still very much up and active, and decidedly somewhere over here in this general direction. I still can't see them though. I won't waste my time over them. They're most likely not worth it anyway. What about the people down there? Well, they all know where I am now. just hoping that they can't make me out and just don't start, you know, opening fire at the first sign of trouble. Which they should be doing, but I just hope that they don't do that. I just hope that. Checkpoint Echo, we were planning on circumventing it, but... To be honest, this loop base is essentially how this game was meant to be played. And I feel like to that end is why most of the enemies can like pretty much just one-shot you. He's supposedly somewhere over there. Charlie went into it right here, so that's something. Okay, we're slowly approaching the position from where we are supposed to launch an attack. Slowly. Slow being the name of the game. I feel like I want to go quicker, but I don't want to risk getting spotted by any of those enemies, so slow it is for now. And I was just noticing how, as and when we get closer to the buildings and the enemies, the frame rate just keeps dropping lower and lower. There's supposed to be like a royal guard right at the mouth of this valley here. I do hope that we do not have to take them out before we can launch an offensive on the main branch itself. Like, if any of them start shooting, I'll just immediately back off. Like, they're just chilling thus far. And good job, little guys. I hope you guys keep chilling. Because in no way I'm gonna be able to take all of you on. If push comes to shove, that is. Oh well. Some folks decided to start shooting at us, and I guess it's our turn to retaliate them. I was hoping to not have to do this, but well, folks noticed us, and it was not really their fault. They were just doing their jobs, but still.
This is King 6 requesting fire mission. Over.
King Our job six, is to make Whiskey sure one. Send your fire mission. Over.
That they can't do their jobs. So, yeah. Well, hell is gonna rain down on you, boys. Hope you're ready for it. I sometimes wonder if my gameplay of Delta Force might just be the most lackluster thing somebody might be watching, but hey, at the end, if somebody's watching it, then I'm happy that somebody is getting some sort of entertainment value out of this. You too? I just shot you. How are you not dead? Yeah. Sometimes bullet hits the ground and makes the dust like bounce all over the place.
This is King 6 requesting fire mission. Over.
That should take care of all the SCUD launches.
Send your fire mission. Over.
The target's have been laser designated. Apuo's soul is right beside it, and he's going to get a taste of artillery.
Destroyed.
I'm just gonna take this guy out.
King 6 to all King elements. Rendezvous with Black Widow at the extraction point.
Roger, King 6. And they did mention like a ground attack helicopter, but I did not see any ground attack helicopters. So to that effect, look at how fast I'm crawling back. This is what I was talking about. I mean, you crawl back so fast in this game. Charlie 1 and 2 are there. Ah, there you are. Alright, Charlie 1 and 2, come. We'll extract together. This way. Right then, Black Widow should be waiting for us at the extraction. And all things considered, this mission could have gone way worse, but I sort of played it safe, to be honest, and I played it really safe, to be honest. And as a result...
King 6, this is Black Widow, en route to LZ.
You were pretty late, Black Widow. I mean, King 6 called for extraction like ages ago. Anyhow, at least you're coming to the LZ. That's all we can ask for, isn't it, Black Widow? Charlie 1 and 2, amazing to see you there. Now, here's to hoping that I don't get shot or die of fall damage on the way down. Wait, you're gonna come here? That's amazing. Right? You're gonna come here, right? No, you're gonna go down there. Okay. Oh no, you're just coming here. That's amazing. That's really amazing, to be honest. Okay, you're just gonna hover in the air? Alright. King 6 is Bravo 1, Charlie 1 and 2. Charlie and Bravo fire teams are RTB. Mission is a success. All the SCUD launchers have been destroyed. I repeat, all the SCUD launchers have been eliminated. Over and out. And that was honestly mission Hound Dog, and I want to say that was like one of the easier missions in the game, but I feel like it felt that way because of how safe I played the game. I think that it would have been like pretty far more difficult if I had not played the game this way, if I had instead just, you know, followed the waypoint markers and just, you know, played it the way that the developers intended for us to play it. But I played it safe, and as a result, even though it might have taken us longer and it was a little more lackluster, it seemed to be a far easier mission to accomplish in this manner. And I don't know about whether the Delta Force in real life would prefer the original mission plan or some variant of the way that I accomplish it, but yeah, I think they would do the latter, because all the special forces are mostly trained for stealth and variants of stealth, essentially. Not letting the enemy know where you are, to be honest. So that's pretty much this strong suit. So yeah, with that being said, this is practically the final mission from Operation Common Resolve, and when we come back, well, it'll be Operation Global Enforcement for you guys. I think I've been saying that for the past few videos, past three videos including this one, I think. But yeah, for me, I've already completed this, and by the time that you guys reach Four Horsemen, which is the secret mission for Global Enforcement, you'll get to know that I'll be covering the quick missions. So, as for this video, and as for Operation Common Resolve as well, this is it. This is the end of the line. Thank you so much for tuning in, thank you so much for watching, and thank you so much for sticking around not only to the end of this video, but to the end of Operation Common Resolve. Until next time, for you guys, which would be Global Enforcement, take care. Farewell, fellow things.